Hi guys, and welcome to this week's video. This video is going to be divided into two parts. The first part I'm going to walk through slides with you explaining classes and how we use them in C#, and then the second part I'm going to jump into Visual Studios and show you how we are going to use multiple forms in our C# project. So let's get to it. What is a class? Well, essentially, as you can see, a class is a blueprint for an object, but the class itself is not an object. This is very important to remember. It describes a particular type of object, but it is not an object itself. Okay, so another thing it does, it specifies the fields and the methods a particular type of object can have. So let's say we have an object ball. Okay, you know the ball you're playing around with, like basketball. You have an object ball. What characteristics that can that ball have? Okay, it has a specific size, it has a specific color, it has a specific volume. Okay, all that you can use in a class as fields. Okay, so think of characteristics as fields you can use in your class. Every object is going to have specific characteristics or different characteristics, and just convert that characteristics into fields. Like the size will be an integer field and the color will be a string field. Okay, and then another thing it does, one or more objects can be created from the class. Okay, so you can use the class to make as many objects of that class as you want. You can create as many balls as you want from that class. You can create a blue ball, a red ball, an orange ball, and so forth. And each object created from the class is called an instance. You should have heard this instance word by now. Once you create an object from a class, it's called an instance. And you will see when we get to the multiple forms projects, you are going to create a lot of instances in your objects. Each instance will be another form for you to view. Okay. Let's move on. So this is a quick example of a class, and you've worked with classes, you just didn't know it yet. Simple way, you have your declaration at the top that starts with the keyword class and then the class name. Always start the class name with a capital letter. And then we have the field. Like I said, it's a characteristics. Now this is a class for a coin, and you can see we have a toss method and a get side up, which returns a string. And the only variable or only field or characteristic that this coin has is which side is up. Is heads up or is tails up? Okay, if it's not heads, then it tails will be above it. So as you can see, we have a comment here that says this public coin is a constructor. Now, if you see, my class name is coin, and my constructors or my method name in this case is also coin. So the method which name is the same as the class name is called a constructor. And I mean the exact same way. Everywhere where the class name has a capital letter, this method also has a capital letter. And very important, a constructor is not a void or a returning method. As you can see, it only says public coin. There's not public void coin or public int coin or public string coin. A constructor stands alone, only with a public and the class name with open brackets. And then inside a constructor, so what a constructor does, a constructor initializes some or all of your field values. Okay, so this is going to be executed at the beginning. When you create an object from the class, this constructor will be executed first. So anything you need to do before any other method executes, you do in your constructor method. Okay. And then we just have a void method called toss, which will toss the coin, and we will display in the message box what side is up. And then we have a public string that gets the side up method, which will only return the side up the method. Okay. So this is a basic class. As you can see, all my methods are inside of my class brackets. Oh, sorry about that. Let's go to previous. All of my methods are inside of my class brackets. Okay. Very important. Okay, so like I said, from our classes, we create an object. So given a class name coin, you can create a coin object. How are you going to use it? Well, going to begin by typing your class name, in this case coin, giving it your own name. This my coin can be anything, and then equals new, and then the constructor, which in this case will be the same as the class name with open brackets. So my constructor is coin, and I'm using the class of coin. So class name, your own name, equals new, always remember the keyword, and then the constructed name of coin. Where can I do this? Where my coin is a variable that references an object of the coin class. Like I said, new keyword creates an instance. There's the instance once again of the coin class, and the equals operator assigns the reference that was returned from the new operator to the myCoin variable. Okay, and once a coin object is created, you can access members of the class with it. So remember, in the previous slide we had a method called toss, and it's a public method. So once your method, this is where public and private comes in very handy, because if your method was private, another class would not be able to see this method. Okay, but because this public void toss method is public, the other classes that you have created an instance of this class can see this method. So now if you go and see, now I have created an instance of my class of my object called myCoin, and now I can access the methods, the public methods and public fields of this class, by just saying my class name that I've just created, my object name I've just created, period, and the method I want to call, the public method I want to call with its parameters. Okay, so that's enough about classes. Let's go and jump into Visual Studios. Right, so we're in Visual Studios now, and like I said before, we are going to use multiple Windows forms in this application. And believe it or not, but when you use multiple Windows forms, you're actually using multiple classes. So what I explained to you in the beginning of the video is going to come in very handy right now. So what I want to do is, I want to open, once I click this button, I want to open another Windows form. And on that Windows form, there's going to be a button that says close. Okay, so very simple. I just want to essentially open another form once I click open another form button. This is video is just so that you understand the basics of working with multiple forms in C#. So in order to create another form in our project, remember here in your Solution Explorer, as you can see, we only have a form1.cs file. Okay, there's not another form file. So in order to create a new form file, you go here at the top to your project, and then the first one, add Windows form. Click on it, make sure the form, Windows form, is selected, and then you rename it to anything you want. My form 2, and be sure to include the .cs extension, otherwise it will not work. And you click simply add, and now you can see in my Solution Explorer that I have another form, or I have another CS file in my project folder. Okay, so that's all it is to create another Windows form. This is my first one, this is my second one. So now you have all the toolbox stuff you can put on there, just like in the single forms. Let's put a label and quickly say this is the second form. Let's just make it a bit bigger. Okay, and then I want a button that will close this form. Oops. Okay. So we have two forms, and I want to close this form on the close button. So let's go back to our first form, which is form1.cs. And you're going to press on your button, and like this is what I want to show you. You can see that you have your class over here. In this case, it's just a partial class, but don't worry about that right now. So we have a class form 1, and if we go to our form 2, and this works the same, if I double click on my close button, you will see that this class's name is my form 2. Okay, so now I want to create an instance of this class. So I want to create an object from this class. Like I said in the beginning of the video, this class is not an object itself, but we create objects from it. Okay, so the name of my object is going to be this class name, and it should be exactly the same as this class name. It shouldn't be anything else but this class name. So remember, my class name is myForm2. Oops, sorry, didn't know what to do there. So let's go to our first form on my button click event. So now I want to create an instance of my second form, my second class. So the way I do that is, you're going to say, what's my name? It's my form 2, and there you can see IntelliSense already senses what you want to do. It says this is the only matching your description, my form 2. So I take my form 2 and I give it any name I want, any name, And I say this should be a new. And once again, you can see IntelliSense already highlights what you want to do. My form to my constructor. Okay. So now I have created an instance of my second form in C Sharp. Okay. So what do I want to do now? Well, it's very simple. I want to display the form, because if you create an instance of the second class, it's not going to display automatically. You need to code it, and you need to say, well, I want this form to be displayed right now. So let's go and say I want any name. Remember, I'm referring to my object now I've created from my form 2.show. As easy as that. And let's just quickly go back to my form 2. And in this button, remember I'm form 2 now, my close button. I just want to say this refers to this form. Well, I want to close it. Okay, as easy as that. Let's run it. Okay, so we see we don't see any other forms now. I only have my form 1. Once I click on the button, there we can see I have another form that's at my disposal right now. Okay, but I can still drag this one around, and I can still drag this one around. Okay, so if I click on the close button, my second form will close, and we're once again back to one form. Now, a useful trick I want to show you. If we go back to our form 1 in our button click event, instead of showing with the show method, if we say any name.showDialog, okay, what does this method do? Well, it shows the form as a modal dialog box. What does that mean? Well, like I said, or like you saw, at the first time I run it, I could have selected my first form and my second form independently, okay? None of them were blocked. But now with the showDialog function, let's see what happens. Okay, I'm clicking on open. You see, now I want to go to my form 1, but I can't. Why? Because my form 2 is still open. That's what's so neat about the show dialog method. Okay, I need to close this form before I can access the form 1 again. Okay, show dialog. So that's pretty neat. Remember that that's modal forms. Once again, I've opened my form 2, but I can't select form 1 because form 2 is still open. Once I close it, I can go back to form 1. Okay, so that's all I wanted to show you guys with classes. This is going to be pretty fun. Enjoy.